You just created a histogram of bin size 20, but we can create a histogram with any bin size, or also called the interval size. This is Interactivate Histogram software, which I really like. You can just input the data here, and then you can see how the shape of the histogram changes when you change the bin size. So here, we're getting bigger and bigger bins, and you see that there are more observations now within each interval. If we keep making the bin size bigger and bigger, eventually it gets kind of hard to see the shape of the histogram because the bin sizes are too big. So here the bin size is about 23. And if we keep going, of course, eventually we get way too much data in each bin and the shape of the histogram isn't even recognizable. So let's get a smaller bin size. Here you can kind of see better the shape of the histogram, that it peaks at around age 20. And so it's really up to you to decide what bin size you want. And it all depends on what questions you want to answer. How much detail do you want? Because at some point, the bin size is probably too small. But at some point, the bin size is probably too big. In this software, you can also see that the sample size is 50. You can see the average, and we're going to get to these statistics later. The link to this software is on the right, so you can click on it and input the data. We shared this data with you in a Google spreadsheet, and then you can see for yourself how the shape of the histogram changes when you change the bin size.